Over the past few videos, we've covered everything from wallet security to sending Bitcoin via email. And now, we're finishing strong with your top questions from Reddit. First up, I thought Bitcoin wasn't private, so what are you doing to ensure privacy? Well, as our CEO Andy Ng recently stated, that's a great question, and you're right. Bitcoin isn't fully anonymous. So I'll let the man himself tell you why we made Proton Wallet.
But then why Bitcoin? Well, Bitcoin already has critical mass. It has strong network effects. So if our goal is to go out there and get decentralized money in the hands of millions, well, trying to replace Bitcoin could be a bit like trying to replace email, right? It's not impossible. But at this stage, most would say that it's probably improbable. So then the approach, if you take the analogy to proton mail, is actually that, you know, you don't replace Bitcoin. The next best thing that you can do is perhaps to try to improve the privacy of Bitcoin as much as possible.
With that in mind, let's think of Proton Wallet like we do about proton mail. We took email, the world's most widespread communication tool, and made it private. And now we're doing the same for Bitcoin. Next up, a hot topic. Lightning or Monero? Where do you stand? Well, here's the deal. Lightning Network? Eventually, yes. We're excited about it. But non-custodial Lightning is still an area of active development. So it's on our radar, but we're waiting until it's solid and secure before diving in. Monero? We get this a lot. As of right now, Monero support in Proton isn't likely. We're walking a fine line between protecting privacy and avoiding unnecessary risks. And as a security-first company, we take that responsibility seriously. All right, next, what's the difference between self-custodial and custodial wallets, and which one is Proton Wallet? Simple answer, Proton Wallet is self-custodial. When you first set up Proton Wallet, we give you your seed phrase. So even if Proton disappeared tomorrow, we won't, you'd still have full access to your Bitcoin. With Proton Wallet, your Bitcoin is as secure as you make it. On the other hand, custodial wallets are the ones where a third party controls your assets. They hold your private keys, so they're responsible for your security. Proton Wallet keeps you in control and gives that responsibility to you. Next up, what's the deal with KYC? Do I need to verify my identity to use Proton Wallet? Nope, Proton Wallet does not require KYC. You can use it completely anonymously if you want to. No need to share your name, address, or what you had for breakfast. However, if you want to buy Bitcoin directly from Proton Wallet using our partners, you might need to provide some personal details depending on how much you're buying and where you live. But that's based on local regulations, not us. So you can keep things as private as you want. And that wraps up our Reddit FAQ. You're now equipped with everything you need to take control of your Bitcoin securely and privately using Proton Wallet. Don't forget to drop your questions below or on Reddit. We're always hanging out there ready to help. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that bell because we'll have even more tips, tricks, and updates coming soon. Stay secure, and thanks for watching.